Well, we don't call it action attraction for nothing. It returns on Friday. That is tomorrow. Maritzburg United, they play Bloem Celtic, like we heard Lorenzo Godinho speaking there. And Ajax Cape Town would like to get back to winning ways as they play host to Duquesne. And then on Saturday, it's the big match. The Brazilians, Bafana Bafana style, they take on Orlando Pirates. And you can also catch Kaizer Chiefs against Polokwane City. Rise and shine. And then on Sunday, we ended off with Bahaha, who hosts AmaZulu. And Chippa United are in action against defending league champions Bidvest. Rob.
All right, without a doubt, looking forward to a great weekend as well of ABSA Premiership Football. And the choices are there as far as the Super Sport is concerned. All right, sitting on Magic Couch right now, as you said, hey, one of the world's finest. I mean, he's played for all the big teams that you can ever think of. If you've played for Barcelona, had a stint at Real Madrid, gone to Chelsea, played for the national team at the highest level, hey, on twice occasions, African Football of the Year. Many, many accolades. Samuel Eto'o, welcome to South Africa.
Thank you.
Welcome to Thursday Night Live. Welcome to Supersport. The African continent is watching. Firstly, just to say, what brings you to South Africa?
Qu'est-ce qui t'a amené ici en Afrique du Sud?
C'est le partenariat que je viens de signer avec Castellaga, qui m'amène une fois de plus dans ce merveilleux pays. Et je suis ravi d'être là.
Because he said that he's here because he just signed a partnership with Casolaga to promote Casolaga 5 against 5. That's why he's here, and he loved this country, because when he's here, he's very happy.
All right, and obviously joining him in the Magic Couch, Alassane Ndo. I would know him quite well. He's one of Senegal's finest footballers as well. That famous World Cup, he was there. When they made their trip. So he'll play. I'll also ask him about the World Cup a little bit later on, though, because I need to use his expertise as well. Just in terms of Samuel, I mean, you were at the CAF Awards and you saw the African Football of the Year being crowned. What did you make of the competition, and why do you think the man from Liverpool deserved that award?
Il dit, tu as été là-bas à la cérémonie, à Accra. Qu'est-ce que tu penses d'élection de
Salah? Je pense déjà que Salah a mérité son ballon d'or. Il a fait une très très bonne saison. Et même les dauphins ont mérité leur place. De manière égoïste un peu, le choix me revenait, j'allais peut-être mettre Aboubakar, qui a aussi fait une très très bonne saison, mais il a le temps de gagner ce ballon d'or.
He said that Salah deserved it. Yeah. He deserved it 100% because he made a great season. Mm. He scored some good goals, and the next one, Mane and
Aubameyang
yeah. as well deserve it. But if you want to be selfish, he want to put Aboubakar there, because he deserves it as well. He played the African Nation Cup. Sure. He played very good. He scored very important goals. But he said that Aboubakar has time to develop everything and to be on the top during the next year.
Mm. I'll touch on the World Cup, though, because it is coming up. It's a World Cup year, and we're all looking forward to that. How much of an impact do you think Africa will have this time around, Samuel?
J'espère que cette fois-ci sera la bonne. On a plusieurs fois essayé jusqu'à arriver en quart de finale. Il est peut-être temps pour notre merveilleux continent d'arriver au soir de la finale. Et l'une de ces équipes qui nous représentera puisse avoir le privilège d'être champion du monde. C'est un rêve fou, mais en football, pratiquement tous les rêves se réalisent.
He said that his hope is this time, this World Cup, one of those five teams, one of them maybe going to brand this cup or push more than we did, or Cameroon or Senegal or Nigeria. We just stopped on quarterfinal. He hoped that one of them push on and go to quarterfinal or go to final. That's what that's his dream.
Sure.
And he said that on football we have to dream to get success, and this is what he's dreaming.
All right. And because there's been a constant cry for you to be more involved, especially within the Cameroonian setup, Samuel? Is that something you still consider a higher role in football in Cameroon?
Dis qu'aujourd'hui, est-ce que aujourd'hui tu te sens concerné par rapport à tout ce qui se passe au Cameroun dans mon
football? J'aide, c'est mon pays, c'est l'endroit où j'aime le plus être, c'est le pays que je veux voir le plus prospérer. Et quand le besoin s'impose, je suis toujours là pour aider.
He said he's here for his country because his country make him big, make him like a big player, and when the country need him for this, to set up everything about this African Nations Cup coming, he's here to help his own country.
We've seen what you've done from a humanitarian perspective. You're always involved, always giving back. What's the ultimate dream for you? What is still there to achieve for Samuel Eto'o post playing football now? What is there for you?
On te voit faire plein d'œuvres humanitaires et plein de bonnes choses. Et maintenant, qu'est-ce que tu comptes faire pour le reste?
Déjà, à travers Castalaga, ce que je veux, c'est que les jeunes qui participeront à ce tournoi à 5 puissent rêver. Le rêve est le début de toute réussite. Il faut rêver, il faut que notre Afrique puisse rêver et rêver grand.
He said, hopefully, that we, what he want to offer to these young kids
now
with Castalaga is offer them the dream. Okay. Because he said that the dream is the beginning of success. That's why he's here to help Castalaga on this promotion for the boy, for the dream to dream for the boy to dream and to get success.
Oh, without a doubt. And obviously, Samuel Eto'o's career was shaped on plenty of dreams, but also plenty of hard work as well, as we've seen his star continue to rise and rise and rise. And we're going to go across now, and we have Vaughan standing by, representing Castle, as from a brand management perspective, chatting to Mueng Mueng regarding the trip to South Africa of Samuel Eto'o.
Thank you so much, Rob. Well, you did mention that I'm standing with the Castle Lager brand director here in Africa. It is Vaughan Kruse. Now, Vaughan, firstly, I want to know from you, what exactly is Castle Lager Africa Fives?
So our dream for this tournament is to create Africa's largest social five-a-side football tournament. This year, we're expanding the concept into 6 countries. And we really want people at the grassroots to get involved.
Talking about grassroots, already we know how much Castle has done for South African football. How did you manage to acquire Samuel Eto'o to come down? I want to know what the trick was.
Well, Samuel Eto'o is undoubtedly the most decorated African footballer of our era. Mm. 4 African Player of the Year awards, 3 UEFA Champions Leagues. But what really clinched the deal for us is that we have a shared vision for what football can do in communities. Mm. We believe that football can be a real force for friendship, for social cohesion and inclusion. And that is our dream, is to bring people closer together. That's what Castle does, right?
Yeah, you certainly did that, because I know that you've already broken down on Twitter. That is because we have Samuel Eto'o on the magic couch. Sheikh Rampedi says, Samuel Eto'o has incredibly done so much for Africa. He's easily one of the best African exports to play in Europe. And this time around, he's right here in Mzansi. So if I want to enter this Castle Lager Africa Fives, how do I do that, Vaughan?
Okay, so the Fives will be running, as I said, in 6 countries. Mm. You simply purchase a promotional pack of Castle Lager. You enter, you and your friends, six players, and then we'll be having playoffs in each country.
Yeah.
The winners of the country will go to Lusaka in Zambia at the end of May. We'll have a big continental final, and those winners will win a trip to Russia to go and experience the Football World Cup with Eto'o as their host.
What? Are you serious?
Absolutely.
Now, the question I want to know, I always want to know, can I enter, please, Vaughan? Because I'm a lady. Can ladies actually enter this five-a-side competition?
Absolutely. This format is open to any amateur football player.
Mm-hmm.
And it'll be great if we can have some women on the field as well.
Thank you so much, Vaughan. Samuel, you're sitting on my spot in the magic couch, so I'm assuming I'm going with you to the World Cup because I'm going to win this.
Well, there's the challenge. There's the challenge coming through there for you, Samuel. Thank you so much. Vaughan, thanks as well to Moeng. Moeng, just giving us a bit of an outline with regards to that. Now, plenty of questions coming through. Somebody was actually on Twitter, said I must ask Samuel Eto'o if he knows a team called Kaizer Chiefs and if he's willing to come and fill the number 9 jersey for them.
Hey? Il faut lui dire merci, mais pour le moment, je suis encore en Turquie et mon avenir passe par là.
He says thank you for inviting him in Kaizer Chiefs, but now he's very happy in Turkish league and he keeping focus on this league.
No, great stuff. I think it was just literally joking about that question. I mean, let's talk about, you know, the kings of African football now becoming presidents of countries. And whether does Samuel Eto'o ever have visions of going in the same direction as what we've seen with George Weah? And that's a lovely achievement that he's had, winning presidency.
Oh, tout d'abord, il faut féliciter notre aîné George Weah parce qu'il ouvre un autre rêve pour certains footballeurs, mais il est aussi important de noter, et il faut que tu le notes, tout le monde n'est pas né pour gouverner, et chacun peut aider là où il est. Et ma vision, c'est celle-là. Je dois aider là où je suis ou là où je serai.
He said that everyone can't be, is not born to be president.
Sure.
He said George Weah is a big brother. He was born to be president. Mm. Yeah, and then he just congratulate him, and all the African congratulate George Weah being president. And he said that he's follow his own direction to help people and to be in close to people, and this kind of promotion like Kasolaga is following and carry on to make this kind of thing.
I know the world football debate has always centered around two players, Ronaldo and Messi, especially for the last 10 years. They've been able to win the Ballon d'Or as well as FIFA Best. Is there a player that you see, Samuel, who is a close third, who, when these two are done, will then become the king of football in the world?
Mbappé. Yeah. Mbappé, Iniesta, il a déjà leur âge. Déjà pour moi, le meilleur joueur de tout le temps, c'est Iniesta, mais bon. Mais Mbappé is going to be the next one.
Okay. So,
Mbappé is going to be the next one, but I mentioned him, Iniesta. He said that for him, Iniesta is the best player in the world.
But do you not think, though, you never got the kind of credit? He's done all the hard work. It's almost like a Xavi player, but he was never given the kind of credit, though.
Il faut lui dire que ce sont les gens qui choisissent. Messi, c'est mon petit frère, il fait des trucs incroyables. Mm. Mais pour moi, Iniesta, c'est quelqu'un que j'apprécie, j'adore sa façon de jouer, et puis ça dépend comment on voit ça.
Il dit, it's about choice. Football is about choice, and Messi is, everybody knows that Messi is flying with the ball. Messi does everything with the ball. He deserves all this golden boy. But he said that Iniesta, for him, is one of the best teammates he have gone for respect for with the ball in and out of the ground.
An amazing, amazing revelation right here on Thursday Night Live. Samuel Eto'o saying that Iniesta, for him, the best footballer in all of football. And also just saying that Mbappe for the future is his choice. After the break, we'll talk to another number one, and then we'll make sure Samuel Eto'o gets down and dances because the band is ready and the artist will be ready. And we'll see whether he likes a little bit of South African music straight after that. So it's all happening. There's a Night Live. Don't go anywhere. All right, as we said, today's shots of blazing hot show right through. All right, we've got a couple of minutes as well to spend and just to congratulate. We're not going to spend too much time with him here. Kagiso Rabada, as you know, a couple of hours back. I won't even say days, because to me it's still a couple of hours. ICC releasing a statement that he is the top bowler in the world when it comes to cricket. Kagiso, welcome. Congratulations.
Thank you, Robert. Thank you for for having me on your show once again. Unfortunately, I couldn't be on the red carpet.
On the magic couch. That's what gave you this magic, my man. You know the story.
Oh, yes. Did I say carpet? My bad.
Don't worry. Magic couch. I mean, obviously, the obvious question everybody will ask is, receiving the news, was it something you expected? And once you received it, how did you digest it? Are you still digesting it? And what sort of pressure does it put on you?
Yeah, the thing is, I always knew that I was there and thereabout. And it was always a dream of mine to be at the top. That's why I played this game the best. And it's nice that it finally come. I'm just very excited. So hopefully now that the challenge now is there.
And obviously it's you break records as a hobby, and you've now become the youngest cricketer in the world to reach that number one status. I mean, that alone again is something to marvel at. What, you're only 22?
Yep.
Yes, I am. I didn't know about that. It took me a while to digest that. I don't think I've even digested that yet. At the end of the day, looking forward, I'm just hoping to maintain and to keep racking up the point.
Yeah, I mean, having been able to leapfrog somebody like James Anderson to the top of the ICC, did you think 2018 would end without that happening? Has this come quicker than anticipated?
Yes, I didn't think I would get there soon. I knew that I was around the leading wicket takers in the test calendar so far, the calendar year. But I didn't know that I would be number one bowler in the world so quickly. But I was just trying to be the leading wicket taker. But obviously, it's just trying to win game team, and everything else just comes secondary.
All right. I mean, what a day. We've got Samuel Eto'o here in our studio, Africa's finest footballer. We've got you, the top man in world cricket as well on Skype. And we look forward to you coming on to the Magic Couch pretty soon in studio. Our Skype is starting to give us a bit of a problem there, Kagiso. But all I wanted to do was just say congratulations, Tata. You keep on making us proud. And that's why I continue to call you King Rabada.
Thanks, Robert. I appreciate it. Next time I'll be on the Magic Couch. No doubt.
Don't worry. I was going to say something, but I'm going to keep quiet. We'll wait for it to happen on the Magic Couch. Thanks so much, Kagiso.
All right, then. Cheers.
All right. Cheers, my man. All right. Great stuff indeed. I mean, where in one show do you have the world's best? Samuel, that guy, number one in the world when it comes to cricket and bowling.
22 ans seulement.
Oui, c'est le meilleur.
Bravo.
Yeah.
Bravo. I understood that. Yeah.
All right. Obviously, Supersport shows a lot of EPL football. And right now, Manchester City seems to be running away with it. Do you think Manchester United will come? You know Jose pretty well. You once scored, and because they thought you're an old man, you made that celebration like that. So we always remember that. But who do you think is going to walk away with the EPL title?
Ouais, parce qu'il dit que Manchester City, ils sont venus ici quand même. Donc, est-ce que tu penses que Manchester United ou Chelsea, les autres, ils vont venir, tout ça?
Oh, ça, je ne peux pas le dire. Mais pour ce que je vois ici en Afrique du Sud, il y a des installations. Et je pense que oui.
Par rapport à la Ligue.
Ouais, c'est possible.
Il dit que c'est possible. Everything is possible. He cannot now say yes, but he wish that the Manchester United or Chelsea come through to this IPL league.
All right, just finally though, what are you planning to achieve with the Africa Fives, the tournament as a whole? Just to wrap it up.
What?
What is he planning to achieve with the tournament itself?
Il dit, qu'est-ce que tu as comme plan par rapport à, et comme rôle par rapport à ce Five Side, ce tournoi?
Ben, déjà accompagner Casalaga à unir toutes ces personnes, à créer ce rêve-là et leur dire que c'est le rêve est permis. Si moi j'ai pu réussir, tous ceux qui participeront aussi peuvent réussir.
He said the plan is for him to get close to those people playing this tournament and have the same spirit, the same vision like Casalaga. Is just make the people close, make people united and keep the dream true. Yeah. Because he said that he when he was young, he was keep dreaming, seeing big players. Now he want to transfer this kind of dream for this player who's going to play this tournament.
Oh, beautiful stuff, man. But when social media has gone crazy the minute they found
it
out
broke. That Samuel,
hey?
It broke.
The internet's gone.
I'm making up tweets right now. I'm joking. Edward Timber tweets and he says, what a legend you have on the show here this evening. But there's one important thing. He says, I'd like to honor him and invite Samuel Eto'o, yourself, Rob, I didn't get the invite to the Kruger National Park.
Okay.
I don't know. Have you been to the Kruger National Park before?
Never.
Never.
Well, Edward Timber has invited you whilst you're doing the Castle Africa Fives. You can definitely go see a couple of nice buffaloes.
All right. We're going to make sure that happens, Samuel. I know you're not a good goalkeeper, but you're a good striker. You put balls in the back of the net. Are you able to catch this one? I've got a bit of homework for you.
You? Yeah.
You going to catch it?
Yeah.
Can I throw it?
Yeah.
Are you sure? Okay.
Netball.
Okay, I've got a pen for you. I've got a marker.
Yeah, please.
Our team would love you to sign this. Thank you so much. All right. All right, Samuel, thank you so much for coming through.
You're welcome.
As well. Stendo, thank you so much for coming through.
You're welcome.
Mueng, you know what? We're going to play some music. We're going to make sure Samuel gets into the groove of South Africa here. Mm-hmm. As I said, Jar is here. Tubbs is here. Take it away, guys.
Like nothing he's ever seen. He stayed for the care for me. Treat me like royalty. Black diamond, the rarest you'll ever find. You wanna hold my hand. You wanna be my man. You say you wanna take me to Ghana. Show me up to his mama. You say you wanna take me to Lagos. Introduce me to Tiwa. Take me to Dubai. I'm Patagonian. I'm his African queen. He wanna love me. One bomb on my floor. One bomb to get me. It must be that African brother. No, there is no other. He searched around the world and couldn't find America. No, no, no. You wanna hold my hand.
I wanna hold your hand.
You wanna be my man.
I wanna be your man.
Say you wanna take me to Ghana. Show me up to his mama. You say you wanna take me to Vegas. Introduce me to Tiwa. Take me to Dubai. I'm Patagonia.
I promise.
African queen. Any wonderland.